The third part of this video tutorial is dedicated to the configuration of the GPIB interfaces which are used during the test. As it was already explained in the second part of the tutorial, we need to control different GPIB devices and, in particular, one function generator and two multimeters. Now it is assumed that these devices are already connected using the proper cables and interface card to the computer of the user, and that they are switched on. In this episode, I will show you how to configure the software and how to check whether the software itself is communicating properly with the GPIB interfaces. Once the program is started, we can click on Edit and in the option GPIB interface. This will open a window from which the user can select the proper GPIB card that is installed on the computer. In my case, I am selecting a National Instrument GPIB card, but of course the user can select the proper GPIB card that is installed on the computer. It is very important to remember that after we change the GPIB interface card, we have to click on OK and then restart the program in order to apply the modification. We click on OK and we apply this setup. Again, from the Edit menu, we select now Edit Signal Source option, and this will open a panel from which we can select the proper signal generator. The signal generator is connected here using the GPIB interface and the proper GPIB address. This parameter is very important and can be obtained at the restart of the GPIB device or using the proper menu of your multimeter or function generator. Once this parameter has been set, you can start to use the function generator. You can also select different function generator using the menu or setting up the parameters in the following panel. Of course, to perform this action, we suggest you to read the manual of your function generator. To make the life of the operator easier, we already included a different function generator that can be easily selected from this menu. Once the proper function generator has been selected, you can simply click on OK to apply the modification and to save them to memory. Now we can click again on Edit, but in this case on the Edit Voltmeter option. From this window we can select the configuration of the voltmeter, which is connected to the computer and is used to connect the different measuring devices. In particular, in this case I will use two different multimeters. The first one, with the GPIB address 22, is connected to the current probe, while the second one, with the GPIB address 23, is connecting to the monitoring loop. Also in this case, you can select different multimeters from the menu, or setting up your own voltmeter, selecting and filling the following windows in the proper way. Also in this case, we suggest you to read the manual of your voltmeter. We can click on OK to save the setting. Now, if we click on this panel, we can see if the signal generator is properly configured. In particular, we can set up a proper frequency, and then clicking on Set, we transmit this information to the function generator. If now you are reading the corresponding frequency of 2 kHz in this example in your function generator panel, this means that the function generator is properly connected. We can close this window and then open the following menu. The following option will allow you to read the measuring of the voltmeter which is set on the GPIB address 23. We can click now on read, and if the device is properly configured, we can read a measurement here. Of course, now the voltage is very low because the voltmeter is not reading a signal. In particular, there is not a magnetic field. That's it for this episode, in which we have explored the GPIB setting on the MagTest software. And in the following episode, we will see more in detail how to configure the required option to perform a test.